Sembawang 教会的弟兄姐妹，大家下午平安。
Good afternoon to brethren from Sembawang.
啊，感谢耶稣啊，让我们能够聚集在他的会堂啊，在下午继续来啊参加这个安息日的聚会。
Thank the Lord Jesus that we are able to gather here this afternoon to join the Sabbath worship.
今天下午啊，小弟要用啊从软弱到刚强的彼得来做彼此的学习。
This afternoon, I would like to use this topic, Peter, who was weak but became strong, as our mutual exhortation.
谁没有软弱的呢？
So who is not weak?
啊，谁没有软弱过呢？
Is there one who has not been weak before?
因为我们大家都是人。
Because we are all human.
带着肉体。
We are in our flesh.
我们仍然有软弱。
We will have our weaknesses.
啊，但是软弱啊，不是羞耻一件事。
But weakness, being weak, is not something that is shameful.
当我们自己察觉啊，我们有软弱的时候。
When we realize that we have weaknesses.
我们应该要勇敢的来承认。
We need to be brave enough to admit it.
而不是找一大堆理由啊，来为自己啊来脱臼，说自己没有软弱，而且逃跑，不要去面对。
And not to find many excuses for ourselves so that we can run away or flee from it.
因为人啊都很怕丢脸嘛，哈。
Because men, we are afraid to be humiliated.
啊，怕面子啊拉不下来。
We are afraid that we will lose face.
啊，其实啊，面子啊值不了多少钱呐。
But then this face, it actually is not that valuable.
要是我们能够放下我们的身段，
if we are able to put down our pride,
看明我们自己的不足的地方在哪里，
if we can see what we are lacking,
那我们才能够啊对症下药，对我们自己的软弱啊重新的去看探讨，重新的靠着主耶稣啊走出来。
Only then we can see the root of our problem and we rely on the Lord Jesus to come out of it.
啊，所以今天下午啊，小弟要用彼得啊，其实一个很好的例子啊，来做我们的彼此的一个提醒。
This afternoon, I would like to use this example, Peter. He's a very good example for us to learn.
我一开头就问，谁没有软弱呢？
That's why I begin by asking, who is not weak?
经过了软弱，才知道自己有多么的软弱，而且不是靠自己，是靠神才能够走出来。
Only by knowing that you are weak, you will know how to rely on God and not yourself.
啊，我们来看路加福音书的22章31到32节。
Luke 22 verses 31 to 32。
啊，路加福音书22章31到32节。
Luke 22 verses 31 to 32。
啊，请念。
Luke 22 verse 31. Simon, Simon, behold, Satan demanded to have you, that he might sift you like wheat. But I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail. And when you have turned again, strengthen your brothers.
好，这边啊，耶稣基督啊，就提醒彼得啊。
So here Jesus Christ reminded Peter.
他说：“西门，西门啊，撒旦想要得着你们啊。”
He said that Simon, Simon, behold, Satan demanded to have you.
好像这个筛子好像好筛你们像筛麦子一样。
So that he may sift you like wheat.
我们看到这个想要筛你们。
So when we see this, he wants to sift you.
啊，当然这个花纹本身就看到可以看到是一个多数了哈。
So in
Chinese 你们
in the Chinese version, we can see that it's a plural.
可是英文好像是 you 嘛 ，you 当然 you 我们要看原文喽，原文当然是指着多数喽。
So in English, you see you, but when we look at the original text, it actually refers to the plural form of you.
也就是说啊，不只是彼得而已啊，是全部的耶稣基督的这些门徒们啊都要有这个。撒旦要来攻击他们。
So this means that Jesus was not only referring to Peter, but all the disciples, that Satan is coming to attack all of them.
所以我们看到耶稣基督老早知道，而且要提醒彼得，
so、see,
提醒他们。
We see that Jesus Christ had already knew beforehand, and he wanted to remind them.
32节。
Verse 32。
但我已经为你们祈求了，叫你们不至于失了信心。你回头以后要坚固你的弟兄。
But I have prayed for you that your faith may not fail, and when you have turned again, strengthen your brothers.
这边说耶稣为他们祈求，为你祈求。
Here it says that Jesus had prayed for them.
啊，但是这个你呢？当然，我们在华文是看不清楚，说到底是单数还是复数啊？
So in the Mandarin Bible, when Jesus said pray for you, the you we cannot see whether is it plural or singular.
啊，所以。要是我们回到那个希腊文去看的时候呢，当然这个就是指着彼得啦。
If we return to
单数
the, If we return to the original text in Greek, we can see that it actually is singular, means it refers to Peter only.
耶稣为彼得祷告。
Jesus prayed for Peter.
使到他能够被保守, 然后他回头的时候, 要来兼顾他的弟兄们。
So that he can be preserved, and when he has turned again, he can strengthen his brothers.
所以耶稣基督老早就知道, 他们啊, 会, 软弱。
So Jesus Christ knew beforehand that they will fall into weakness.
甚至啊, 他会, 甚至彼得啊, 会三次不认主。
And Peter will even deny Jesus for three times.
可是彼得怎么回答呢?
But what did Peter answer?
33节。
In verse 33.
彼得说啊, 主啊, 我就同你下监, 同你受死, 我也甘心啊。
Peter said to him, Lord, I am ready to go with you both to prison and to death.
这个就是彼得对耶稣基督, 所告诉他, 所提醒他的, 非常自傲, 非常自信。
So after Jesus told him, then Peter responded in much arrogance and also confidence.
他不知道他有多么软弱。
He did not know how weak he was.
我们当然不怀疑彼得对耶稣基督的爱。
Of course, we do not doubt the love Peter had for Christ.
可是彼得不知道彼得里面本身啊是软弱的。
But Peter did not know that in him he was very weak.
所以我们来看第一点。
Let us look at the first point.
就是22章的31节。
In chapter 22, verse 31.
就是撒旦想要得着你们。
Satan demanded to have you.
把彼得放在这个筛子中来筛。
And to put Peter in the sieve so that he can be sieved like wheat.
其实要是正正的说起来, 他这个彼得算不了什么了。
So actually, Peter is considered nothing.
因为 这个把它筛下来就是这些粗糠啊，就是 worthless shaft.
So after being sifted, he is like worthless shafts.
所以这些粗糠就是丢掉了。
So then these shafts will be thrown away.
没有什么价值的。
They are of no value.
但是我们从彼得所写的书信啊，
But from the epistles of Peter,
你后来才发现说啊，彼得对他很自信的，后来他明白了他有多么软弱。
So Peter, looking back, he knew how weak he was.
你可以看到彼得在写彼得前后书啊，他事后啊回顾回想，他原来啊没有去听从耶稣基督所给他的警告，以为他很刚强。
So in 1st and 2nd Peter, we can see that when Peter reflected and recollected, he realized that he did not listen to Jesus' warning and he thought that he was very strong.
所以事后他回顾回想啊，他写出了这个 彼得前后书啊，来警告我们，对我们自己的软弱，对我们自己的不足的地方在哪里。
So after he reflected, he wrote 1st and 2nd Peter to warn us to so that we will know where our weaknesses are.
我们来看一段我们昨天晚上也有看的哦。
Let us look at a passage that we have read last night.
好像我们最近都是讲彼得哈。
It seems that of late we are talking about Peter a lot.
好，那我们来看彼得前书的5章第8节。
1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8.
彼得前书5章8节。
1 Peter chapter 5 verse 8. Be sober-minded, be watchful, your adversary the devil prowls around like a roaring lion seeking someone to devour.
一个没有经历过那种情况啊，不会把这个描述啊讲出来。
If a person has not gone through adversity, he will not have said these words.
因为他自己亲身体验啊，耶稣警告他，跟他讲了，他还很自信啊，后来跌倒了。 才知道，哎呀，原来啊，这个魔鬼啊，真的是吼叫的狮子啊，遍地流星啊，寻找可吞吃的。
So he realized that he was too confident and he did not heed Jesus' warning, then he fell, and he realized that the devil is just like a roaring lion prowling around.
所以对于他自己三次不认主的这个事迹呢，对他来讲是一个在他脑海里啊，很清楚的。
So he was The denial of Peter towards Jesus Christ was still very clear in his mind.
所以他现在写这段事迹啊，是要来告诉我们，哎，你们要警醒啊。
So he wrote this passage so that we will be vigilant.
什么是持守呢？
So what does it mean by be watchful?
Sober.
Be sober.
也就是说你自己要有一个自律。
It means that you need to have self-discipline.
也就是说你对于你自己的信仰，你自己要去好好的来看重。
It means that you have to place emphasis on your own faith.
不要愚昧的来去做你的信仰的功夫。
Do not foolishly or haphazardly do this work of salvation.
我们每天都过着一个因为上班嘛，所以都我们很有距离啊。
So because we have to go to work every day, we have discipline.
所以你几点啊、起床？几点刷牙？几点吃早餐？几点搭公车？那使到你不会迟到上班，对吗
？So you have certain timings to wake up, to wash up, and to take the public transport and to go to work, so that you will not be late.
那我们都这样每天的都这样的一直、按照这个程序来做。
So we follow this daily routine every day.
不知道我们的信仰生活也是有纪律吗
？So I do not know if our life of faith has this sort of discipline as well.
几时祷告，几时读经啊、哦？几时啊、要啊、来思考神的话啊、哦？与神亲近，我们有没有这样的一个纪律呢
？Do we have the discipline to have a fixed timing to read the Bible, to pray, to draw near to God?
要是我们能够这样做的话，当然我们就能够啊来持守。啊、神的道理
If we can do so, then we can preserve ourselves in the word of the Lord.
那我们才能够警醒、啊、
Only then we will be sober-minded.
彼得为什么说 要警醒呢
Why did Peter say that we need to be vigilant?
因为当耶稣跟他讲的时候，你三次不认我的时候，他不警醒啊。
Because when Jesus told Peter that you will deny me three times, he was not watchful.
甚至耶稣还告诉他们，在哥斯门祷告的时候，他说警醒祷告，免得入了迷惑啊。
And even in Garden of Gethsemane, Jesus told them that you have to be watchful and pray lest you fall into sleep.
他们都愿意跟耶稣基督一起。
They were willing to be with the Lord Jesus Christ.
可是肉体是软弱的。
But their flesh was weak.
啊，因为软弱，他没办法持守下去。
Because of their weakness, therefore they were unable to hold on.
所以彼得啊，在这里啊，在提醒我们呐、啊，哎，不要像他这样。
So here Peter reminds us that we should not be like him.
尤其啊，对于我们的属灵的这种陷阱啊，我们更加要注意啊。
Especially for spiritual traps, we have to be very alert.
啊，有哪一些东西啊，会让我们在属灵上啊，在属灵的这个陷阱里面、啊，我们掉进去而出不来呢？
So what are the things that will cause us to fall into these spiritual traps and we will not be able to come out of it?
很多时候是在我们不知不觉当中啊，掉进去的。
Many a times we fall into these traps unknowingly.
啊，这个是啊，我们要警醒的啊一个部分啊。
This is something that we have to be vigilant about.
我们真的要好好的来去看待。
We have to treat this importantly.
所以彼得才告诉我们，我们要好好的去看。
That is why Peter tells us that we have to look at this properly.
那在这一节呢，他也谈到你的仇敌啊。
Here it also talks about your adversary.
我们知道我们的仇敌吗
？Do we know our enemies?
我们的仇敌当然就是魔鬼啦。
Our enemy is the devil.
他是一个公开的仇敌啊。
He is a public enemy.
啊，他是不择手段，而且是不惜一切啊，一直的来攻击我们。
He will use unscrupulous methods to constantly attack us.
你可以看到，从亚当夏娃一直到耶稣基督，一直到现在，他没有停止来攻击啊、神的。神的羊，这些耶稣基督的信，这些信徒。
So we can see from the time of Adam and Eve to the time of Jesus Christ and to our time, the devil is constantly attacking the sheep of the Lord and the Christians.
甚至啊，他是一个控告者，他在神的面前呢、啊，一直的来控告我们。
He is also an accuser. He constantly accuses us before God.
记得吗？他在神的面前来控告约伯啊。
Do you still remember he accused Job in front of God?
啊，就是在约伯记的第一章啊。
In Job chapter one.
因为神说啊，你没有看到约伯吗？他比一切的人呐、啊、更加完啊、更加啊、完整呐、啊。
So because God told God asked the devil and say that Have you seen my servant Job? He is more blameless and upright than anyone in this world.
可是魔鬼怎么讲
？But what did the devil say?
他说，因为你犯了一个围栏呐、啊。
It says that because you have a fence around him.
所以呢，他持守你的道理啊。
That is why he holds on to your truth.
你把这个拿掉。
If you take those away.
你看他会怎么样
？Then you will see what he will do.、
所以神允许让他来试验约伯，可是不可以取他的命。
Therefore, God permitted the Satan to attack Job, but cannot take his life.
我们看到这个魔鬼啊，一直的来攻击我们。
We see that the devil is constantly attacking us.
不管是在约伯记所讲的，一直到我们看到耶稣基督警告彼得啊，说这个魔鬼想要得着你们呢、啊。
Regardless of the book of Job, or when Jesus Christ told Peter, he said that the Satan is demands of them.
我们来看启示录十二章的第十节。
Let's turn to Revelation chapter 12,
verse 10.
Verse 10.
启示录的十章十二章的第十节。
Revelation 12 verse 10.
我听见在天上有大声音说：“我的神的救恩、 能力、国度，并他基督的权柄，现在都来到，因为那在我们面前，昼夜控告我们弟兄的，已经被摔下去了。
Verse 10, And I heard a loud voice in the heaven saying, Now the salvation and the power and the kingdom of our God and the authority of his Christ has come. For the accuser of our brothers have been thrown down, who accuses them day and night before our God.
这个撒旦啊，一直的来控告我们啊。
Satan is constantly accusing us.
那我们是不是应该要更加警醒呢？
Therefore, shouldn't we be more vigilant?
我们不应该落入到这个陷阱里面给他来控告我们。
We should not be ensnared and give him the opportunity to accuse us.
这个波特哈
，This Michael Porter.
那他是一个策略师，他也是一个大学的教授。
He was a strategist and he was also a professor in the university.
他在这个哈佛大学，他是一个教授。
He was a professor in the Harvard University.
他就教了这个策略管理。
So he taught about strategizing.
Strategic management.
Strategic management.、
他说，要是你要走在前头
，He said that if you want to walk in the front,
那你必须要在这个竞争的前面。
Then you have to be in front of the competition.
也就是你不要落人后了。
It means that you should not fall behind.
那你要一直在前面，就是说你要很努力啊，一直走在前面，你不可以落人后。你落人后，当然你就给你的竞争者夺过了，然后你就是。输了。
It means that you have to work hard to always stay in the front and not behind, because if you fall behind, then your competitor will catch up and you will lose.
今天呢，我们应该也要在我们的这场属灵战争的前方。
So likewise, we have to be in the front line of our spiritual battle.
否则的话
，otherwise，
我们就落人后，就给魔鬼吞吃了。
We will fall behind and be devoured by the devil.
这些百姓出埃及的时候也落人后，也因着这样给亚玛力人来追杀。
Likewise for the Israelites, when they were in the wilderness, some of them fell behind and they were attacked by the Amalekites.
我们来看生命记的25章
Deuteronomy chapter 25,
17-18节
verses 17 and 18.
生命记25章 17-18节
Deuteronomy 25 verses 17 and 18. Verse 17, remember what Amalek did to you on the way as you came out of Egypt, how he attacked you on the way, where you were faint and weary and cut off your tail, those who were lagging behind you, and he did not fear God.
十八节的下半段说击杀你近后边软弱的人并不敬畏神。这边告诉我们这些百姓在弱人后的时候呢，也给这个敌人亚玛力人来追杀。
So it says here that those who were lagging behind, they were attacked by the Amalekites.
我们不知道魔鬼是用什么方法，什么这个策略来攻击我们。
We do not know how the devil will attack us and with what strategies will he come for us.
但是有一点呢，他是永远不会改变的。
But there is something that will never change.
他永远会用这个策略。
He will always use this strategy.
不管是从亚当一直到现在，他都是用同样的策略来去攻击我们。引诱我们，让我们离开神。
From the time of Adam to our time, he will use the same strategy to attack us, to tempt us.
我们来看约翰一书的二章。
Let us turn to 1 John chapter 2.
约翰一书的二章。
1 John chapter 2.
我们来看15-16节。
Verses 15-16. Verse 15. Do not love the world or the things in the world. If anyone loves the world, the love of the Father is not in him. For all that is in the world, the desires of the flesh and the desires of the eyes and the pride in possessions is not from the Father, but is from the world.
所以魔鬼会用这种方式来攻击我们。
So the devil will use these methods to attack us.
就是肉体的情欲、眼目的情欲，还有今生的骄傲。
Desires of the flesh, desires of the eyes, and the pride of life.
我们从亚当他是怎么来在信仰上倒下来的呢
？So how did Adam fail in his faith？
就是这三个。
It was through these three methods.
眼目的情欲
，the lust of the eyes，
肉体的情欲
，the lust of the flesh，
还有今生的骄傲
，and the pride of life。
因为他说这个可以可当吃啊。
Because he was told that this could be food to eat。
而且呢，可以眼睛明亮，如神这样。
And your eyes will be open just like God.
当然我想像神这样啊。
Of course, I want to be like God.
知道什么是善恶啊。
To know what is good and evil.
他不满足啊。
He wasn't contented.
所以他就违背了神的 吩咐啊。
Therefore, he went against the instructions of God.
我们的始祖亚当夏娃就是这样的来啊，得罪神，违背神，离开神的。
This is how our ancestor Adam he went against God. He sinned against God and left God.
你可以说那个罪魁祸首是那只蛇。
So you can say the culprit is the serpent.
你可以说那个主谋啊就是魔鬼。
You can say the conspirator is devil.
啊，就是魔鬼用着那个蛇来引诱他们。
It is the devil who used the serpent to tempt him.
可是亚当夏娃，神跟你讲的那么清楚，为什么你不听呢？
But then God has already told you clearly. Why did you not listen?
因为他想像神。
Because he wanted to be like God.
所以要是今天我们不持守，我们不警醒，我们不知道我们的敌人是谁啊，我们很容易啊就给这三个事情啊来打倒了。
Today, if we are not vigilant and we do not know how enemy is, we will be defeated by these three things.
肉体的情欲、眼目的情和今生的骄傲，这三个都是他一直来用，甚至到耶稣的时代，他也用同样的方式来攻击耶稣，但是耶稣用着神的话来阻挡，来胜过。
He constantly used these three methods to attack humans. Even for Jesus, he used these three methods, but Jesus overcame.
今天他也用着同样的方式来攻击我们。
Likewise, today he used these three methods to attack us.
我们清楚吗？
Are we clear about this?
我们可以看清他的诡计吗？
Can we see through his snares?
啊，所以撒旦要得着我们。
So Satan wants us.
我们清楚的知道他的攻击吗？
Are we clear about his attacks?
这个是我们应该要好好的去反思的。
This is something that we need to properly reflect.
好，我们来看第二点。
Let us look at the second point.
我们回到路加的二十二章的三十三节。
Let us turn back to Luke chapter 22, verse 33. Verse 33, Peter said to him, Lord, I am ready to go with you both to prison and to death.
这个是彼得啊，在当下听到那句话的时候，他要让耶稣基督，你放心啊，你不用担心。你下监你死我都甘心啊，跟你陪你去啊。
So Peter responded and wanted Jesus to be rest assured and say that I am ready to go with you both to prison and to death.
彼得不知道他所讲的话是血中的自信以及刚强。
So Peter did not know that what he spoke was out of impulse and confidence.
所以这第二点呢就是血中的自信与刚强。
So the second point is fleshly overconfidence.
我们很多时候啊也像彼得这样。
Many a times we are just like Peter.
彼得不知道他有多么软弱。
Peter did not know that how weak he was.
耶稣基督已经告诉他了。
Jesus Christ had already told him.
可是他自己本身不知道他里面的软弱有多么深。
But he did not know how deep and how severe his weaknesses was.
你可以看到彼得在还没有否认耶稣啊，他已经认出耶稣就是神的儿子。
You can see that before he denied Jesus three times, he already knew that Jesus was the Son of God.
这个才在不久之前而已啊。
This happened not long before.
我们来看马太的十六章。
Let us turn to Gospel of Matthew chapter 16.
马太十六章的十六十七节。
16 verses 16 and 17.
马太福音书的十六章十六十七节。
Gospel of Matthew chapter 16, verse 16 and 17. Simon Peter replied, "You are the Christ." The Son of the Living God. And Jesus answered him, Blessed are you, Simon Bar-Jonah, for flesh and blood has not revealed this to you, but my Father who is in heaven.
那这边啊，当然是谈到主耶稣啊，跟他的门徒啊，去做一些勉励了哈，在一个外面了哈，就是该撒利亚、腓立比啊，来做一些勉励。
So here he talks about how Jesus encouraged his disciples at a place called Caesarea Philippi.
啊，那他在那里呢，就跟门徒啊一起来一起来勉励哈。
So he exhorted his disciples there.
他就来问门徒，你说我是谁呢？
Then he asked his disciples, "Who do you say I am?"
只有彼得讲的正确的答案。
Only Simon Peter gave the correct answer.
他说你是永生神的儿子。
He said that you are Christ, the Son of the Living God.
但是耶稣基督告诉我们
，But then Jesus Christ tells us,
不是因为彼得的灵性啊更加刚强。
It was not because of his flesh and blood.
啊，不是他的灵性啊比别人更高。
It wasn't because he had better spirituality than others.
都不是。
It wasn't.
十七节讲得很清楚。
In verse 17, he says,
他说因为这不是属血肉的指示你哦。
because it was not flesh and blood that revealed this to you.
因为属血肉的，他不认识，他也不知道是神的儿子哦。
Because for those who are flesh and blood, they do not know who Christ is.
乃是
He is the Son of God.
在天上的父指示你。
But it is the Father in heaven who revealed to him.
所以他认识耶稣是耶稣是神的儿子，是因为父告诉他的。
So he knew that Christ was the Son of the living God because the Heavenly Father had revealed to him.
这边告诉我们说啊，不是凭着血肉来认识啊啊在上面的事。
So here it says that in order to know the things of heaven, it is not based on flesh and blood.
但是是靠着啊父，就是神的道理、神的真理，让我们来认识这位耶稣基督的。
But it is through the Father, through the Holy Spirit and the Word of God to know who Jesus Christ is.
所以你才发现说，哎，彼得，你不是认出了耶稣就是神的儿子吗？你应该灵程是比别人高啊。
So we might say that Peter, you already know that Christ or Jesus Christ is the Son of Living God. So you should have better spirituality compared to others.
可是这边耶稣很清楚说，不是凭着血肉。
But here Jesus Christ clearly said that it is not because of flesh and blood.
也告诉我们啊，凭着血肉，我们没办法认清啊。
So it goes to tell us that if we use our flesh and blood, we will not know clearly.
你可以看到彼得啊，他是第一个冲在前线的。
You see that Peter was the one who always goes in the front.
那他看到某一件事啊，他就马上激发了一些感触啊，他就想要做了。
So every time he sees something, he becomes emotional and it triggers him to do something.
啊，比如在那个变貌山的事情。
For example, on Mount Transfiguration.
啊，他看到那个荣光，他看到这个荣耀。
When he saw the glory and the glorious light.
他就说这里真好啊。
He said that how good it is here.
那个事迹记载在路加的九章那边哦，三十多节了哈。
It is in Luke chapter 9. In Luke chapter 9.
啊，三十多节，你们去看一下啊。
So you can read it by yourself.
啊，他说这里真好。
He says that how good it is to be here.
啊，所以呢，他想要搭三座棚。
So he wanted to make three tents.
啊，给啊耶稣啊，给以利亚，给摩西。
One for Jesus, one for Moses, one for Elijah.
他不知道在讲什么。
And he did not know what he was saying.
他只知道说啊，很荣耀，看到这里真好啊，就是这样。
So he only knew that it was so glorious and it is good to be there.
所以很多时候他都是凭着血气啊。在做事啊。
So many a times he do things out of impulse.
那有一次耶稣基督不是走在海面上吗？今天早上我有讲啊。
So this morning I've also talked about how Jesus walked on water.
哎，他看到耶稣走海面，他也想走海面啊。
So when he saw Jesus walking on water, he wanted to walk on water as well.
当然他就请耶稣啊，让他能够走在海面上。
So then he asked Jesus to allow him to walk on water.
啊，因为风暴。看不到耶稣，所以就沉下去了。
But because of winds and storms, he was unable to see Jesus. Therefore, he sank.
所以他很多时候都是凭着自己的血气去做事。
Therefore, many a times he worked based on his impulse.
当然，我们不否认他对耶稣有信心了啊。
Of course, we do not deny that he has faith in the Lord Jesus.
可是他都是冲在前面的了。
But many a times he is the one who goes first.
那当耶稣被捉的时候
，But when Jesus was arrested,
他做了什么
？What did he do?
他就拿了刀。
Then he drew out his sword.
啊，把这个祭司的仆人的耳朵啊，把它削掉嘛。
And he sliced off the ear of the servant of the priest.
啊，这个在记载在约翰的十八章第十节啊。
This is recorded in John chapter 18, verse 10.
那耶稣基督讲怎么讲呢
？So what did Jesus Christ say?
收刀入鞘。
Keep your sword away.
啊，难道我不可以叫我的父派天使来吗
？So am I not able to ask my father to command angels?
啊。所以呢，彼得，你可以看到他每一件事啊，都是凭血肉。
So we can see that everything that Peter did was based on impulse.
所以呢，他在当下只看到他的那种血气方刚。
So you can only see his impulsiveness.
这个就是彼得了。
This is Peter.
所以彼得真的不知道他血中的自信以及刚强。
So Peter really did not know his overconfidence in his flesh.
但是这种刚强不会让他的信仰。啊，更加成熟。
But this sort of fleshly strength will not make him mature.
所以，雅各长老这样讲。
Therefore, Elder James said this.
我们来看雅各书的一章二十节。
Let us turn to the book of James, chapter 1, verse 20.
雅各书一章二十节。
James chapter 1, verse 20. James 1, verse 20. For the anger of man does not produce the righteousness of God.
当然，上文有谈到啊，亲爱的弟兄姐啊，亲爱的弟兄们啊，你们知道说啊，但你们个人要快快的听，慢慢的说，慢慢的动怒哦。
Of course, the preceding verse said this. Know this, my beloved brothers. Let every person be quick to hear, slow to speak, slow to anger.
我们很多时候啊，都很容易动怒。
Many a times we get angry very easily.
因为我们都是选择听我们要听的。
Because we always choose to hear or listen to what we want to listen to.
那后面所讲的，后面所解释的，我们都把它挪掉了。
So we always omit explanations that come after that.
所以很多时候啊，我们就会产生误会。
Therefore, many a times misunderstanding arises.
所以雅各长老不是没有原因的这样 写出来的。
So James wrote this not because they're without reason.
他说你为什么慢慢的说呢？
Why did he say you have to be slow to speak?
因为你要听清楚啊，听得明白啊。
Because you have to hear, you have to listen clearly.
那你才不会因为你很快要讲啊，但是你把它听清楚了啊，了解了整个来龙去脉，你才不会发脾气啊。
You have to listen carefully from the start to the end. Only then you will not be so quick to anger.
那你才不会动怒，而且圣经说的这个动怒的啊，不能够成就神的义啊。
So even the Bible say that, if the anger cannot fulfill the righteousness of God.
那我们很多时候就很容易啊，就马上就说啊，就是这样啦，你就是这样，所以呢。就吵起来了。
Many a times we will make a judgment and say that you are like this, therefore conflict arises.
所以啊，这个凭血肉啊，凭血气的做事啊，不能够持久，而且也不会让处理事情啊处理的妥当而且完整。
So doing things out of fleshly impulse will not resolve matters amicably.
所以我们今天呢、啊，我们应该要来审查自己。
Therefore, today we ought to examine ourselves.
我每次这样讲啊，我都是包括我自己在内的。
So when I always tell you this, I include myself.
你不要以为说啊，我比较好啊，所以可以站在讲台跟你们大家讲，不是啊。
It is not because I think I'm better than you, therefore I can be on the pulpit to tell this to you.
我跟你们一样，傻妈傻妈的。
I'm like you.
啊，一样了，都是人啊。
Because we are all men.
带着肉体啊，血肉啊。
We are in our fleshly body.
一样都要学习啊。
We have to learn.
你们在台下学，我在台上学。
So you're learning, while you're listening, and I'm learning on the pulpit.
啊，神透过啊这个他的道理啊来讲解给大家听而已。
And
神透过这个讲道者把道理讲出来而已。
So God is trying to convey this message through the speaker.
所以我们呢、啊，不要凭血肉来处理事情哦。
Therefore, we should not resolve matters based on our impulse.
啊，不要血气方刚哦。
We should not be too impulsive.
啊，要慢下来。
We have to slow down.
慢一拍。
We have to be slow.
啊，那我们就听得清楚，我们就不会做出错误的决定了。
We have to listen clearly in order to not make the wrong decisions.
那我们就不会凭血肉来做事了。
That we will not do things out of our impulse.
因为圣经说怒气不能够成就神的义啊。
Because the Bible says that anger cannot fulfill the righteousness of God.
我们来看最后一点。
Let us look at the last point.
啊，就是二十六章的马太二十六章的五十八节。
Matthew chapter 26 verse 58.
马太二十六章的五十八节。
Gospel of Matthew chapter 26 verse 58.
58,
and Peter was following him at a distance, as far as the courtyard of the high priest, and going inside, he sat with the guards to see the end.
当然路加的22章54节有谈了，彼得远远地跟着。
Of course, in Luke chapter 22, verse 54, it also says that Peter followed him from afar.
所以这第三点呢，就是远远地跟着主。
So the third point is to follow Jesus from a distance.
一个远远地跟从者。
So a follower who follows from a distance.
很容易成为这个沿途许多陷阱的被害人。
So very easily there will be people who will be harmed.
为什么呢？
Why?
没有一个人没有一个人是刚强的。
Because there is none who is strong.
所以呢，要是你远远的来跟着耶稣基督呢，在你的信仰生活上，要是没有一个人刚强的可以远远的来跟着耶稣。
So there is no one who is strong who will follow Jesus from afar.
因为你远远跟着耶稣，你就会落人后了。
Because if you follow Jesus from afar, then you will be one who falls behind.
那你就不能够来持守你的信仰。
Then you will not be able to hold on to your faith.
所以雅各长老这样讲。
Therefore, Elder James said.
我们来看雅各书的一章八节。
Let us turn to Book of James chapter 1 verse 8.
雅各书的一章八节。
James chapter 1 verse 8. Verse 8.He is a double-minded man, unstable in all his ways.
所以雅各长老这样的来告诉我们。
Therefore, Elder James tells us,
这个心怀恶意的人，在一切所行的路上都没有定见。
The person who is double-minded is unstable in all his ways.
那什么是心怀恶意呢？
What is a double-minded man?
就是说你里面有两个人啊。
It means that there are two people in you.
一个呢是专注神。
So one focuses on God.
另外一个呢，就专注这个世界。
And the other one focuses on the world.
那 你要怎么专心 来专注神呢？
Then how can you be totally focused on God?
你不可以说我是multitasking 的，就是说我随心所欲啊，不是，就是一心三用，四用五用了哈。
So I cannot say that I am a multitasker, therefore I can put my attention onto many things.
你说没问题啦，我开车我可以传卷信，可以吗？开车可以传卷信吗？
So can we drive and text at the same time?
不行啊
！No, we cannot.
万一撞到人怎么办
？Because you might get into an accident.
不会的。
Then you might say no. I won't.
我已经练习了很久了。
I've already practiced for a long time.
警察都回家了，没有看到。
So the police have went home and they will not see me.
啊，所以不用担心。
Therefore, do not be worried.
我开着车也可以传简讯。
I can drive and text at the same time.
其实我真的有点担心。
So sometimes I am a bit worried.
尤其是那些 Grab 那些 motorbike Grab 嘛。
Especially the motorbike Grab drivers.
一手开着那个摩托单车，另外一手就在那边传简讯。
So one hand they are driving, but the other hand they are sending texts.
那个 motorbike 就这样啊，我在他旁边开车，我都怕。
So their motorbike will be swerving to the left and right. When I drive beside them, I am quite worried.
我真的很想告诉他，哎，你在开摩托车，你不是开车呢。
So I really wanted to tell him that you are driving a motorbike and not a car.
他是一心好多用啊。
So he was multitasking.
我不能够。
I cannot do this.
我也很怕。
And I am quite afraid to do this.
我也是说，不要在开车的时候又传简讯啊。
And then I say, do not drive and text.
因为这个是对你自己危害自己的生命，也危害那些公路使用者。
Because you are threatening your own life and also others.
可是对我们的信仰，我们绝对是一心一用，而且是要用在神的身上。
So in our faith, we have to be single-minded and we have to be totally focused on God.
你不可能又爱世界又爱神是不可能的啦。
So you cannot love God and also the world at the same time. It is impossible.
当然你出去在世界要赚取这个工作，赚取这个钱财来生活，那是应该的。
So it is true that you need to work in this world to earn a livelihood.
我不是说你不需要去做工了哈。
I'm not saying that you do not need to work.
啊，当然你需要上班，你需要赚取钱财来喂饱你的家人，那是我们应该要做的事啊。
So you can go to work and then you can earn a living and put food on the table. This is what we ought to do.
你已经赚够了，那你的家人也过得一个很舒适的生活了。
When you have earned enough and you can provide a comfortable life for your family.
可是你认为还不够。
But then you still think that it's not enough.
哦，我要过得更加好。
I want to lead a better life.
哦，我今年换宝马，明年要换那个 Bentley 啊 ，Bentley。
So I want to change from a very luxurious car to another very luxurious car like Bentley.
啊，我希望说我改车还有自己的私人飞机啊。
And I even hope to have my private jet.
哦，那在这个 District 11买那个 condo 还不够，我要在那个圣淘沙那边啊买那个 Sentosa Cove， 而且要看。巴淡岛的那个方向。
And it's not enough to have a condo in District 11. I need to buy a house in Sentosa Island overlooking Batam.
哎，圣经怎么讲呢
？So what did the Bible say?
我们来看马太福音书的六章二十四节啊。
Let us turn to Gospel of Matthew chapter 6 verse 24.
六章二十四节。
Chapter 6 verse 24. Matthew chapter 6 verse 24.No one can serve two masters, for either he will hate the one and love the other, or he will be devoted to the one and despise the other. You cannot serve God and money.
所以啊，这个心怀恶意啊，就是说一心两用的人啊，你没办法完全的来侍奉神，因为你爱世界或者你爱神，就两个事情而已。
Because a person who is double-minded cannot serve God wholeheartedly, because you either love the world or God.
所以到底你的心啊是容纳什么呢
？So what do you have in your heart？
那雅各长老告诉我们
，Elder James tells us。
我们来看雅各书的四章四节。
Let us turn to Book of James chapter 4 verse 4。James chapter 4 verse 4, you adulterous people, do you not know that friendship with the world is enmity with God? Therefore, whoever wishes to be a friend of the world makes himself an enemy of God。
所以啊，我们不可以贪爱世界。
Therefore, we should not love the world.
因为爱世界的就是以神为敌啦。
Because those who love the world are in enmity with God.
所以呢，我们应该要把我们的目光啊放在神那里。
Therefore, we have to place our focus on God.
啊，就是把我们的焦点放在神那里。
To place our focus on God.
那我们才能够啊过着一个信仰的生活，而且是以神为友的。
Only that we can lead a life of faith and a life that is in friendship with God.
那我们虽然住在这个世界，但是呢，我们仍然是忠心的来侍奉神的。
Even though we live in this world, yet we serve God faithfully.
那远远的跟随远远的跟着主。
To follow the Lord from afar.
那彼得啊，在这在这个事情上呢，是独自的一个人在跟随。
So Peter was following from afar alone.
我们看回来马太的26章58节。
Let us turn back to Gospel of Matthew, chapter 26, verse 58.
马太26章58节。
Matthew, chapter 26, verse 58.
58节啊，26章的58节，好，对。
Chapter 26, verse 58. Verse 58, and Peter was following him from a distance as far as the courtyard of the high priest, and going inside, he sat with the guards to see the end.
其实啊，彼得是充满了恐惧啊。
So actually, Peter was filled with fear.
那当然，因为这样啊，也经历了很多过度的这个惊怕跟惊恐。
But because of this, he faced a lot of terror.
所以很多时候啊，我们在我们的信仰生活上啊，我们不可以独自的一个人来过。
Many times in our life of faith, we cannot go through it alone.
我们呢、啊，应该要有我们的属灵的同伴。
We ought to have spiritual companions.
啊，这个很重要。
This is very important.
因为当我们在软弱的时候，我们的属灵同伴可以拉我们一把。
Because when we are weak, our spiritual companions can hold us up.
啊，传道书也说啊，二人总比一个人好。
In the book of Ecclesiastes, it says that two is better than one.
所以啊，我们今天在我们的信仰生活上啊。我们为了不要远远的这样跟着、啊、我们需要我们的属灵同伴来让我们能够跟得上，而且是跟到耶稣那里。
In our life of faith, in order to not follow Jesus from afar, we need spiritual companions to bring us and to hold us so that we can follow him closely.
那我们再来看另外一点，就是远远跟着不认主。最后一点呢，当然就是彼得啦，后来他就自己惭愧啦，哭了。
The last point is that Peter followed Jesus from afar, but in the end, he felt remorse and he wept.
我们来看路加福音书的二十二章。
Luke 22.
六十一到六十二节。
Verses 61 to 62.
路加二十二章的六十一到六十二节。
Luke chapter 22, verses 61 to 62. And the Lord turned and looked at Peter, and Peter remembered the saying of the Lord, how he had said to him, "Before the rooster crows today, you will deny me three times." And he went out and wept bitterly.
鸡就叫了。
And the rooster crowed.
啊，主转过身来看彼得。
The Lord turned and looked at Peter.
彼得想起主的话。
And Peter remembered the words of God, the words of the Lord.
就说他出去哭了。
And the Bible records that he went out to weep.
我相信那种彼得那种哭哈、哦，从心里啊、哦、哭出来啊、哦，是很惭愧、很愧疚、很对不起耶稣。
So I believe that in the tears of Peter, it was filled with remorse and guilt towards the Lord Jesus Christ.
耶稣老早跟他讲了。
Lord Jesus had already told him beforehand.
可是他自己却没有察觉自己的软弱。
But he did not realize or see his weaknesses.
所以他在那个哭里面啊，也是一种对他的主啊、不敬。
So in his weeping, he also felt this disrespect to his master.
所以他痛哭流泪。
Therefore he wept bitterly.
当然，至少他哭了以后，后来得到圣灵，他就得到能力。那他就能够为神来做工了。
But at least after he wept, he received the Holy Spirit, and he also received strength. Therefore, he could work for the Lord.
可是那个卖主的犹大呢
？But what about the betrayer Judas?
他后来就是被定了以后，他也惭愧了，他就把那个三十银两丢还给这个祭司啊。可是已经太迟了，公会的人了，已经太迟了。
So after Jesus was crucified, he felt deep remorse and he returned the 30 silvers to the priest, but it is of no use anymore.
已经没办法转回了。
So there is no turning back.
他就出去啊，上吊了。
And he went out to commit suicide.
一个三次不认耶稣，一个出卖主，可是他们的下场都不一样。
So one denied the Lord Jesus three times, and the other one betrayed the Lord Jesus. Both their outcome was different.
一个懂得怎么来为自己的软弱、为自己的不足来哭。
One knew how to cry or weep for his weakness.
所以他能够转回来。
Therefore, he was able to turn back.
所以到最后，耶稣基督死了又复活。
So in the end, after Jesus died and resurrected,
他就来找彼得了。
Then he came to look for Peter.
在他没有问彼得之前呢, 他问小子你有东西吃吗?
Before he talked to Peter, he asked children, do you have anything to eat?
事后喂饱他们以后,
after he fed them,
耶稣就问彼得三次, Jesus, 你爱我吗?
Jesus asked Peter for three times, do you love me?
这个是给他三次的来表达。 爱的机会啊,
it was three times of an opportunity for Peter to demonstrate his love or declare
这个在
his love.
约翰福音书的21章嘛, 15到17节嘛。
So this is in John chapter 21 verses 15 to 17.
我们都很清楚的, 这个耶稣跟彼得的一个这个很精彩的对话。
So we are all very familiar with this interesting conversation that transpired between Jesus and Peter.
其实这个也是耶稣基督啊, 慢慢的把彼得, 这个软弱的彼得, 让他重新的站起来。 把他挽回来。
Jesus slowly and gradually turned Peter back and brought him back.
你可以看到后来的彼得啊, 被, 挽回来以后,
you see that Peter, after being brought back or restored,
在五旬节那一天得到圣灵,
he received the Holy Spirit on the day of Pentecost.
蛮有胆量,
he was filled with courage and boldness,
蛮有力量,
filled with strength.
讲话那个道理啊, 借着圣灵的感动啊, 能够切入人的心啊, 3000人能够得救。
And through the moving of the Holy Spirit, the truth he spoke could actually pierce through 3,000 people's hearts.
你后来看到彼得被捉了，他不怕了。
You can see that after that, Peter was captured, yet he was not afraid.
而且他能够很勇敢的在这个被捉的 这些官员面前啊, 来为神来证道。
And he was able to courageously preach before his captors.
甚至被捕释放了以后，继续的来勉励信徒，一起来祷告，为这事情来祷告，求神赏赐给他胆量，来传扬福音。
And after he was released, he asked the members to pray together with him, to pray for him so that he will have this boldness to continue preaching for the Lord.
所以彼得能够得到刚强，是因为耶稣基督。
Peter was able to be strengthened because of Jesus Christ.
可是他自己也要认清自己的软弱,
but he himself had to see his weakness as well.
要为他自己的软弱来哭啊,
and he had to weep for his weakness.
那才能够啊, 来重新得力啊。
Only then he can regain strength.
所以保罗这样讲,
therefore Paul said,
我们来看, 彼得, 哥林多前书的10章12节。
Let us turn to 1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 12.
哥林多前书十章十二节。
1 Corinthians chapter 10, verse 12. Verse 12, therefore let anyone who thinks that he stands take heed lest he fall.
所以啊，今天啊, 我们要认清我们自己的不足的地方在哪里，软弱在哪里, 那我们才能够免得我们自己啊, 不谨慎而跌倒。
Therefore we have to know our inadequacies and also our weaknesses, lest we fall.
所以呢, 自己知道自己的软弱, 那我们才能够对症下药。
Only if we know our weaknesses, then we can treat the source.
那我们才不会凭着血肉之气啊, 来追求我们的属灵的生命。
Only then we will not pursue after our spiritual life based on our fleshly desires.
我们是凭着耶稣基督的真理, 耶稣基督的道理, 还有生命的道, 来帮助我们, 来 过这个属灵的生活。
But it is with the word of Christ, with the word of the Lord, that we lead this life of faith.
我们再也不凭着血肉之中啊, 来行事。
And we will not do things based on our fleshly desires or our impulse.
我们也不凭着血肉之躯来, 去征战。
And we will not also fight with our fleshly bodies.
而是凭着圣灵的能力跟带领, 我们来迎战。
But based on the power of the Holy Spirit and the guidance of the Holy Spirit, that we will win this battle.
那我们才能够为耶稣基督来打胜仗。
Only then we will be victorious for the Lord Jesus Christ.
那我们才能够刚强像彼得这样。
Only then we will be strong like Peter.
求神啊, 来帮助我们。
May the Lord help us.
我们来唱诗。
Let us sing him.
470首。
470.